baptized, right? So, but you know, look at this beautiful gown that he's wearing, this baptismal gown. I think his was a great grandmother. Great grandmother that bought it for him. And several generations have worn this. In fact, Sarah wore it here when she was baptized a couple years ago, right? When you were just a little baby, you wore this gown, that's right. So, but you know, I was wondering, why do we have these special gowns for baptism? You ever wondered about that? Why these kind of special, beautiful gowns for the sacrament of baptism? You know, actually, it goes back to the very first days when Christians were baptized, and they would actually be baptized, and they would take off the old garment, and they would put on a brand new garment for the newly baptized. And it was a way of saying that we're putting on a new life with Christ. Paul writes in Colossians to put on Christ, to clothe ourselves with kindness, meekness, righteousness, and humility. So the baptismal gown really becomes a symbol of our new life in Christ, the life into which Wyatt is about to be baptized. So Matthew, you would drive him forward. Well, here are the words of our Lord Jesus Christ. All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything that I have commanded you, and remember that I am with you always, even to the end of the age. So obeying the word of our Lord Jesus and confident of his promise, we baptize those whom God has called. In baptism, God claims us and seals us to show that we belong to God. God frees us from sin and death, uniting us with Jesus Christ in his death and resurrection. By water and the Holy Spirit, we are made members of the church, the body of Christ, and we are joined to Christ's ministry of love and peace and justice. So let us remember with joy our own baptism as we celebrate this sacrament.
On behalf of the session, I present Wyatt August Hutter to receive the sacrament of baptism.
Amanda and Ryan, do you desire that your son be baptized? And relying on God's grace, do you promise to live the Christian faith and to teach that faith to your child? And do you, as members of the Church of Jesus Christ, promise to guide and nurture Wyatt by word and deed with love and prayer, encouraging him to know and follow Christ and to be a faithful member of the church? Do you?
Yes.
Amanda and Ryan, as God embraces you within God's covenant, I invite you to profess your faith, trusting in the gracious mercy of God. You turn to Jesus Christ, accepting him as Lord and Savior, trusting in his grace and love, do you? And will you be Christ's faithful disciple, obeying his word and showing his love? Then let us stand and with the whole church confess our faith in the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty,
Maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, the only Son of our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits on the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, signs of your grace. We praise you that through the waters of the sea you led people of Israel
into the freedom of your promise. We praise you for sending Jesus, your Son, who for us was baptized in the waters of the Jordan and was anointed as the Christ by your Holy Spirit. Through the baptism of his death and resurrection, you set us free from the bondage of sin and death and give us cleansing and new birth. We praise you that in baptism you give us your Holy Spirit and teach us, lead us into all truth, filling us with a variety of gifts that we might proclaim the gospel to all the nations and to serve you as a royal priesthood. So pour out your Spirit upon us and upon this water, that this font may be a womb of new birth. May all who now pass through these waters be delivered from death to life, from bondage to freedom, from sin to righteousness. Bind them to the household of faith, guard them from all evil. Strengthen them to serve you with joy until the day that you make all things new. To you be honor and praise and glory through Jesus Christ, who with you and the Holy Spirit reigns forever. Amen.
Present you with a candle, certificate, and children's Bible. Please accept these gifts from the congregation as tokens of our commitment to help you teach the Christian faith to Wyatt and to help him grow in the love of God for me.
God, we welcome you.